And despite all our efforts, that's just how it goes sometimes. You get all your troops killed, you end up at the back of the map, making smart aleck jokes, and just generally taunting the enemy. Life be like that sometimes. What? No! No! Oh my goodness! No! What are you doing, Step Spear? No! I'm stuck! Hey boys and girls, it's KnightStalker here. Welcome along today to Valley Fortress Siege. Check it out, man. I've just about finished the challenge with these Varangians, and I tell you what, I'm never picking them up again unless they're super buffed or something later. So we're going to take them in today. We're going to take the Houndsmen, because it seems like a lot of you had a nice time watching the video of the Houndsmen last week, so we'll take them again. And I'm going to take my indefatigable, that's a lovely word, Imperial Shields. So let's get on with this match then. Teams are looking pretty nicely balanced there, and we should be able to have a nice sort of balanced and even game. So, let's go. And here we are with our beautiful loading in animation. So, on this map there's one thing that I feel like I have to do at the start of every game, and if you've been watching for a while, you'll know exactly what it is. Whoops, wrong direction. So, we're going to go over here. We're going to put our guys under the cover of this wall here. We're then going to completely stuff up the corner. But what we're going to do is, we're going to take out this the Scorpio. There's a blue Scorpio just over on the right there. And the reason we have to take that out is it because when you're aiming, by the way, you put it right down on its little rabbit ears like this. There you go. That one, it doesn't matter that the cannon got destroyed. who called me weak? Because all this area here that I'm standing in, and these stairs, and down by just in front of the Varangians, they're actually too hard up against the wall to be shot, but all of that area there can be bombed by that Scorpio, and it can put your team off being willing to defend, and of course it can cause significant casualties as well. So at the start of the match on this particular map, Valley Fortress, make sure that one of you or one of your team, better if you take responsibility for it yourself, go over there and make sure you take out that one Scorpio. There's not any real way, even with like Falcos here, to stop the siege engines coming in on this map. So I typically don't even try. It's just too hard, too costly, too hard, and widely unsuccessful. So don't bother trying to prevent the siege towers coming in. Just try and take out that one little thing over there, and just move on with your day. Right, I've got this green grape shot cannon. Every time I get green artillery, I just sort of use it madly. What do I want to do with it? Can't get up on there. Maybe if I can... I like to just set up stuff like this. And we'll set it up nice and early as well, so any of our team can use it. The timer will time out by the time that the enemy push units up the wall, I think. I hope. So, we'll just move them up casually so that they're ready for when we're ready to go. When they make a shield wall in that direction, they're really not going to be harmed by anything. The only thing that can really hurt it is like a musket, or maybe a maul runs down. We might set it up here, actually. I see these people already. Come on. Come on. Boo. Cannonballs. From the sky. Death rain. This is a terrible shield formation to be in. Assists, I'll take it. But yeah, this circular formation is terrible for shields to be in, and I've no doubt that you'll witness very soon why that is, if they stay there. They'd be better off in the square block formation facing away from me. Give him a heal, though. Isn't it interesting how well that unit fits underneath the little circle template, targeting template for the Falconetti. It also fits nicely under a musket template, for their bomb or their caltrops. It also fits nicely under a trebuchet template. But this unit is not strong enough for me to be able to hold there. It's a very weak unit. And we're just going to have to run. If I sent it in there, it would die and it would only get a couple of kills, and then we've achieved nothing. So it makes no sense whatsoever just to lose it for absolutely no purpose. It wouldn't save the A point. We didn't have enough people defending it, so let's just move on. We'll just move on with that day, man. A little bit tilted that no one decided to defend. Just a little bit. Except that one guy with shields who made a mistake. Ooh, tasty? Not tasty. So, on this map, one other thing that you need to understand is that the B point is totally undefendable. Unless you're going to have a mass, you know, half your team or more there to try and defend it, it's just not worth defending it. The best place on the entire map to defend is here. And typically you won't defend on the C point itself, because it's very exposed and they can shoot archers and things up from the supply point below. So, I wonder if we should just get another piece of artillery. A ballista will probably do the job, I think. Yes. Yes, it will. We've got a little nice little shield wall. One thing this unit is good at is making a little shield wall. It's not the best at shield walls, but, you know, if you're going to use it to its strengths. And this is its strength. Sitting here and getting punched in the face. 300 and something leadership of face punching. It's just not a good unit, man. Can you tell? Can you tell I'm not a favourite, not a fan of this unit? So, we have a shield wall, we have a pike wall, and we have a Viking cluster. I won't call it a wall. Pew! Anyone finish him off? Yes, nice. So now we're just going to chill. Anyone who wants to take that C point is going to have to sit underneath our ballista and underneath our falconetti. We won't make too much effort to defend it because it's so exposed over there. Ooh, no, I have to go lower, I think. Can we get him? He jumped! Bye, Pike. See you all. But we will try and kill him. Easy. Injured the other guy, too. Now we've got our range in, so we should be able to kill him. Very nice. And then we should be able to kill her. Not a death, just 90% damage. What if we were to kill them? Not a death? Well, I think I killed the horse. But certainly a 90% damage. Can anyone finish them off? And we are being attacked in the back, but one of the things about getting over on the A point so quickly, and then just giving up the B point, is that you must defend this area as well as you can. Like, you can't run off to one side because they'll take the supply point here and then it's all over. It's too easy to push into the main, right? So, well, it's not easy. Ooh, missed. It's not easy, but it's a damn sight easier than if we defend here, because we've got a supply point 20 meters from us. We've got good solid defense here. So we can't all just run off, but you see how on the map there, they're pushing through the side hallway. They're just at the top of the stairs here, see? I'm sure the cavalry will deal with it. Oh, Wolfie boys! Two. Splat. You know, the Varangians can deal with lower tier units. I wouldn't want to put them up against, like, Prefecture Guard, man. I think Prefecture Guard would absolutely own them. I think Landshark's Charge would own them. Prefecture Pike Charge would own them. Blue Halberdiers are a lot better this season. I used to hate them, but they're really good this season. They would own them. Like, the unit, just it can be beaten by blue tier units easily. In fact, there are two green tier units I can think of that would destroy it too. The Pike Militia, because they have no CC resistance in their shield wall. Although, once they switch to their 2 ability, they would have CC immunity as long as you're cycling them in the right pattern. But also, I do like the, nice couple of cavalry kills. I do like the green iron cap muskets. They would do lots of damage to this unit too for their 145 odd leadership. Yeah, another couple of cavalry. That wasn't a total waste. Do we need to transition, is the question. I don't know, is the answer. We're going to have a peek. But we don't want to abandon... Yeah, I know. And I'm keeping an eye on it. I won't give up on you, friend. I won't give up on you. I believe in you. I'm watching it very closely because I will have to run back in support if we have to. Not that I'm offering a load of support with this unit, but it is what it is. Que sera. But we will come and help our little friends here. It looks like they're having a party without us. And what's a party without us, really? I ask you. Is it even a party if we're not there? Viking party. If we get it, oh, look at that. Get into the ranged units will cause a bit of damage. That's not terrible. Just about any unit can beat ranged units in close combat. But look, we're just getting slaughtered. Absolutely slaughtered. So, 14 kills with this unit. And that includes the ones that we got with the ballista. So, 15. So, we've already only got, what, 13? Such a weak unit. But, like I say, I'm looking forward to finishing not just the challenges, but the doctrine challenges for this unit as well. And then I will probably never use it again. Anyway, we've got one of my favourites now. We've got the Wolf Boys. The Dogochers. Dog Archers. Dogochers? You can get a skin for the Dogochers too, for the dogs. See how they're Dobermans instead of, I don't know, what were the other ones? Like mutated Border Collies. Right, yes, we do need a transition. See how important keeping an eye on the map is. These people would be in a little bit of trouble if we weren't arriving now. They need some DPS. Don't know why the stalwarts are retreating. But they don't need to, because all we're going to do is this. Pew, 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 pew. Where's some numbers? There's some numbers. Look at those numbers. I love numbers. Oh, 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 oh. Big flamey death. Unfortunately, we're going to drag the dogs through the treb zone, but life be like that sometimes. You can't have your cake and eat it too, which is a really odd saying, because what good is cake if you can't eat it? Anyway, how about some more numbers? I like numbers. Dugga 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 dugga. Woof 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 woof. Lots and lots and lots of numbers. Oh, and some cavalry too. I like cavalry numbers. The Kishigs, I think. Yes, they are. So we'll just absolutely slaughter them, no trouble. And this guy's going to die, and then everyone behind him is going to die too. It's a good day to be a dogger. Although now we're just archers because we've got no dogs left. We have expended that resource. I might just have a quick peek. I don't think we need to be here. We're getting smashed, man. 600 troops to 870. It might look like we're defending properly, but it's actually looking pretty dire for us. They have, what, 20% more troops than us? You know, and that's after they've used their peasants and things to assault the walls, right? So all their peasants would have died early. Can we reach there? So if we target here, we should be able to shoot beyond. Would you like to shoot, please? Hello? There we go. That's better. Just cause some damage for free. Trebuchet coming in. One of the good things about the Dogchers is that they're really fast, especially if you've got the top line, which also gives them the Hunter's Instinct or whatever it's called, the bleed while you do the pinning shots. Now hopefully we can pick off some heroes, because heroes tend to underestimate archers. But these are not your average archers. These are hero hunting archers. Pew, pew, pew. Oh, that's what happens when you place the circle further than your range. They can actually do it, and they do this like plunging fire looking thing, just watching out for trebs, but it's extremely inaccurate. So I tend not to do it. Here we go. It's a good day to hunt heroes, is it not? No trebs? No trebs? If we place the circle again, we should be able to get some more shots in. Some of those are doing up to 2,500 damage. I wonder what we're hitting. Anyway, we ain't got no ammo left. But I feel confident that we helped their team hold this side. Ooh, there's someone there. No, no, no. Anyone aware of that? They're still winning too. They've got significantly more troops than us. We'll have to do something about that, I think. Let's endeavour to do something about that. We'll just remove a few modar from the field. That'll certainly help the team. Nobody in range. Maybe someone? One hit for 800, right. Yep, our team is encouraging us not to give up. It's very strange that they outnumber us sort of like 4-3 and aren't pushing. Mind you, you've got to scout it first, don't you? That's fair enough, I guess. I wonder if we can stand here when they start pushing in and start blazing away at them. We'll have to be careful though, this is a treb zone. Also, any ranged heroes would love to get a hold of us, particularly a musket. A musket will absolutely ruin this unit. Do you see how they completely derp on single target? Like anything that's moving single target. They're still a bit buggy in their targeting system. in terms of trying to hit units that are moving or zigzagging. And, ow, what's going on? Stupid short bow. We're doing a very good job of keeping them back. So I have to keep moving my unit now and then because, well, basically I don't want to get trebbed. 3 kills, 7 assists. I could do with more. Could always do with more. Yeah, our team's holding this really well. Despite the, you know, we're now up to, we got 30% less troops than them now. It's quite significant. I wonder if we can... I don't really want to get shot by the short bow is the thing. Wreck that guy's day though. Quad kill. You don't get those very often as a longsword. Oh, hello. Coming straight up, huh? I have bad news for you. I have hero hunting archers. Oh, phew. Right, now you're dead. Now you're coming back from this. But he was brave. Don't know quite what he was achieving. They've still got way more units than us. Why would you charge in on your own? Just keep moving, keep moving. Treb bad. I wonder if we can go and kill some of these Falconetti. This is a bit risky. I do risk losing the unit here. One of the disadvantages is a short range. What? Oh yeah, target the tree. That makes a load of sense, guys. Whoop-de-doo. Oh, ow, 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 ow. We lost 2 of them. 2 dodges. Somebody's capturing the endpoint. I am going to go and see if they require assistance because, well, we had heroes. Hero hunting is what we do. No, it was not a genuine push. It was just someone trying to back cap. What are they doing? They outnumber us so much. Oh, hello. See if we can do that indirect fiery thing. I don't think we're going to have much luck. It's so inaccurate when we do it like this. Nap. Oh, hero. I wonder if we can shoot down here, can we? No. But we will shoot these foolish heroes. We will shoot the foolish heroes. There we go. Thank you, archers. God of War. God of War. Head of Snake. Sounds like the start of a poem. I cannot see any red dots on the map. There we go. There's some. This is very weird. They still outnumber us. Who can we go kill? I still have the shields left, so even if I lose this unit, it's not going to be the end of the world. I see we're making a push down the stairs on the right there. We might possibly join that. That seems like a good idea. We've got it covered up here, I think. So let's go have a peek what they've got hiding from us. Hopefully it's not something weird. Because, you know, every time you go poking around in people's stuff, you run the risk of finding something weird, right? Zoom, zoomy, zoomy archers, like zoomy, zoomy dogs. Let's kill us some heroes, hey? Look at the bleed stacks. So good. Dead. Kill him as well? Go and kill him. Or maybe we can kill his muskets down the back there too. I'd be alright with killing the muskets. We've got much higher DPS than the muskets, even though they have very high impact. Maybe a maul? Can we kill a maul? And kill his horse. Just about out of ammo though. Alright, we're now cannon fodder. Only got a minute left. Note how the doggos there, see, they don't try and attack with daggers or anything stupid like that when they run out of ammo. It's not true for all archers. See if we can use them as cannon fodder while we fight the tercios here, because we definitely do not want to get like a drawn out fight with tercios. Their triple tap is nasty. How do I know the tercios? They have a long straight sword on their hip. Also, they didn't throw any bombs at me, so there's that. We'll get some capture points, we'll get a small amount of ammo, and maybe we'll get to shoot again. Let's go. They don't outnumber us anymore, that's for sure. Alright, zoomy dogchers, let's go. Pew! Aw, he died too quick. We'll heal our friend here in the last 6 seconds of the game. And that's GG. That was a very strange game. Very strange game. Heaps of XP. Nice S tier game. We didn't get an MVP despite all of that. A noble cause. You don't ever get that as a longsword. That's so rare. Thank you, doctors. We did 1 million damage. We took 853, which is pretty standard when you spend most of the game as an archer. 451 for the doggos and a pathetic 12 for the Varangians. Wow, our team decimated them. Holy heck! 19-1-16. That's insane! Mokiki Nero, you're the boss! And we even had another person get 14 kills as well. That's what's happening. They couldn't use the units because Mokiki and this other guy were just murdering the heroes before they could command the units. 70! We had 70 hero kills and they had 18. What a stomping. Oh well, boys and girls, I hope you learned something new or you just enjoyed the battle. Thank you so much for coming to my channel.